started yet, so if you want to do something embarrassing, you could now.
I'm going to do plenty embarrassing throughout this, so don't worry.
And you do know I did already start it, right?
Okay, yes, okay, absolutely.
Cool. Here with Matthew from Dell. Peter, we went and saw IBM, we saw HP. Let's go see Dell. And the other major server vendor, Oracle, Sun, Oracle, not here. So, three. So what are we looking at here?
So we're looking at a Dell M1000E blade chassis with a variety of blades in it. And since we're at VMworld, I'd like to talk about things that are unique about Dell that deliver true benefits with virtualization. Understanding always that we adhere to three main tenets, being open, capable, and affordable.
Oh, quit reading from the script. Quit reading from the script. What do you have here, wise? What are we looking at?
So this right here is a new server from Dell. This is the M710HD.
Two sockets.
Two sockets. Westmere EP with 18 DIMM slots.
Okay.
What makes this good for virtualization is that we've done some innovation. This right here is the LAN-ON motherboard, but you'll notice that I just actually removed it from the motherboard.
You did.
So out the gate, this is a... There are two Broadcom, two port NICs.
Yeah.
But now I have choice. I can choose two Broadcom dual port or two Intel dual port or 10 gig E or a converged network adapter.
Okay.
Whatever my needs are. And I have choice not just from the factory, but to upgrade down the road for LAN on motherboard.
Now, one of the things we were talking about with both IBM and HP, one of the big hurdles, it's the bottleneck you get to when you start virtualizing is memory. And being able to throw enough memory at the virtual workloads in order to make them all run and get higher CPU utilization.
Absolutely. So that's why we've introduced the M710HD with 18 DIMM slots.
Yeah.
One of the challenges is with Westmere EP, when you go over 12 DIMMs, you actually go from 1333 down to 800.
Oh, really?
So that can affect performance. However, if my concern is capacity and not necessarily performance, then this is a great fit. So with 6 cores per socket and 12 cores overall and 18 DIMM slots, this might be a really good fit for something like virtual clients.
Okay.
Or for larger VMs that need memory but aren't necessarily latency affected.
Now, are you guys doing a 4-socket blade?
As a matter of fact, we are. Interestingly enough, we were the first ones
to... Did I just throw you a softball there?
Absolutely.
Because I actually wasn't sure.
We were 4 months to market ahead of HP with our M910. So it's a 2-to-4-socket expandable Nehalem EX architecture with 32 DIMM slots.
So what, two-way blades that you attach together when you say expandable?
No, it's just a single full-height blade.
Okay.
With four sockets and 32 DIMM slots. When I say expandable, I mean that I can start with two sockets and 32 DIMMs. Wait a second, Matt. If it's a 4-socket server and it only has 32 DIMMs, how can I get to all 32 DIMMs with just two sockets populated? So that's where Dell innovation comes in being open. So, and when we adhere to standards, we deliver fantastic results, and we don't have to step outside.
Get off the script again, damn it!
It's that we adhere to what Intel gives us without having to go out and create a proprietary architecture. What we did create was something called the Flex Memory Bridge. What that does is it extends the memory bus out to those additional 8 DIMMs per socket, and also terminates the quick path interconnect so that with just a 2-socket configuration, I can have 32 DIMM slots.
So you're using the QPI to get out to the other 16 slots.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Which has actually delivered the highest 2-socket VM mark benchmark score.
Holy crap.
And 4 months before anybody else was able to deliver Nehalem.
Amazing. Incredible.
And using standard technology that's offered by the platform.
Now, are you guys going to remain, how do I want to put this? It's not necessarily a negative, it's a different philosophy in that four socket is as big as you guys go, right?
Absolutely.
And you're not moving to an 8-socket or anything above 4 for
so
a single system image?
So when we look at how you scale VMware, right, and how many VMs I can get per node. And when I pay attention to what we like to call your failure domain, how many VMs am I willing to lose at a time if I lose a node? I mean, yes, everything will come up using VMware HA, but how long is it going to take to bring those nodes up? It can be a long time. It can be an arduous process.
Yeah.
So despite the availability that's built in with redundant embedded hypervisors, which is also unique to Dell, on the M710HD and the M910, right here, redundant SD slots on the top and on the bottom.
Okay.
We're going to great lengths to ensure that we're up as much as possible, building in reliability. Things like pins on the servers and on the modules instead of on the mid-plane, right? So that if I bend a pin, all I have to do is replace a blade and not a mid-plane.
So really, then, when you talk about scalable x86, you're more in the camp of let's not just put too many eggs
in one
particular basket.
Yeah, what we're saying is let's scale out logically in a way that makes sense. Because even if I have 2 4-socket servers, right, or 4 2-socket servers, I really have the same capacity across that. However, it's less expensive to add a 2-socket node than a 4-socket node. So when I grow outside of the capacity, in order to scale in the 4-socket world, I have to add another 4-socket server instead of just adding 1 2-socket server. It's a lot less expensive, not only from platform acquisition costs, but also from a licensing perspective. So it delivers a great return on the investment.
Well, assuming your workloads will fit within the 2 sockets and all
right.
that.
Sure.
Okay.
And generally speaking, like I was saying with the M910, with 2 sockets, Intel Nehalem EX with 8 cores per socket, that's 16 processing cores in a 2-socket server. That's pretty impressive.
Yeah.
It is.
Yeah.
And what is VMware like more than anything? Is it processing cores? More than anything, it's memory.
Yeah.
So with those 32 DIMMs for those 16 cores, we've got a winning platform.
Okay, good. Well, thank you very much. Appreciate the time.
Appreciate your opportunity to let me talk.
So we both appreciate
appreciation.
Both of that.
Absolutely.
So we appreciate each other. So you have no idea how I'm going to edit this either.
I don't.
We could really rip beyond this.
Oh, I know.
Okay.
I don't doubt that for a second.
Good. So I'm going out to Adobe and grab a whole bunch of special effects stuff. This is not going to be pretty. Noxious clouds coming out of your mouth.
Oh, it's not going to be pretty because I'm already not.
Well, you're not a bad-looking guy.
Thank you.
But I don't mean anything by that. So
I didn't.
Let's just let this go on that uncomfortable moment.